Hello guys, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. Here I welcome you, myself Prashant Kumar. So let's begin with a new topic, Python tuples. We can pronunciate it a tuple, tuple, but I will say tuple because it depends on you or how you are going to pronunciate this word. So in Python we have some data types, as a list is a data type, string is a data type. So similar we have the tuple is a data type. It is similar as the list. I think you already got the list video, so please if you have not seen that one, you please check it first of all. Okay, so it is similar as the list, but there is a one difference. It is immutable and list is mutable. Okay, immutable means you cannot change the content. Okay, once you create a tuple, you cannot change. So let's see, here we are going to begin. What is the tuple? A tuple is a container which holds a series of a comma separated values, items or elements between the parentheses, such as this one. Okay, so here you can see the example of this one. So my dear students, I think we have used these quotes to write down the string. Okay, this bracket to write down the list. And here we are going to use this bracket to write on the tuple. After that we will learn the dictionary. So this is the dictionary, the paracentesis. Okay, so we have finished this one, we have finished this one, today we are going to finish this one. So we will come to know what is the dictionary after this class. Okay, so here we are going to start. The tuples are like list, except they are immutable. Okay, similar as the list, but only the difference. As in the list, we can write down the numbers, alphabets, floating values, so all the things similarly we can do here. But it is immutable, that is mutable. Okay, so definition is clear to you. Here are the some examples to create a tuples. So here it is the empty tuple, means if you are writing this simply, bracket is coming in this way, so it is the empty tuple. 1, 2, 3, separated by comma, tuple of strings, 1.2, 4.5, 5.7, 0.7, it is a floating point, A, B, C, it is a tuple of characters. Now, here is the mixed value. I think in the list I have told you, there is a roll number, I think Rohan 1 and some school name was there, I forget that one, but here you can see A, 1, it is a character, it is a integer value, character, floating value, and here is a zero, it is a string. So here you can see that it is a mixed type. Okay, so next one is tuple of strings. Hey, it is a string, it is a string, it is a string, so it is a tuple of strings. So I think it is pretty clear to all of you that how you can create the tuple. Now how to create the tuple in a Python, that is very important. So here we are going to see how to create the tuple. So here you can see you have to write down a key variable equals to that O on N of the dead bracket. If you are going to print this one, this is the example you will get. It is the example of empty tuple. Okay, now different types of tuples we have. So here we are, I'm going to show you how you are going to create this one. Create a tuple with the different data types. Tuple, false, 3.2 and 1. So here you can see, this is the string, this is the boolean operator, this is the floating point, this is the integer, and I am printing all these values. So you just copy down this, you can write down this program in on your computer screen and check the output. Okay, it will show you this output only. And similarly, we can create a tuple with one item. So make it sure, my dear students, 4 comma. Here it is 4 comma. If you can write down tuple in this way also. So it is 4 comma, that means you are writing a tuple, this value is as a tuple. So here you can see the output, it will come as it is. Okay, I think these things are clear to you. Now the next is the tuple with numbers notation. Okay, so one thing is also there, if I will do this here, vice versa, so how it will give the output. If I am going to write down bracket 4 comma bracket, so if I'm in the place of this, if I'm going to write down this one, so it will give the similar output. Okay, it will give the similar output. Second thing, another thing, create a tuple with the number notation with the parasynthesis. So here you can see, I have used this 4, 7, 3. Comma is important. Okay, comma is important in the tuple. So comma, you please don't forget to put the comma. If you are going to write down like this, if you are printing, this will give you the output for this. Okay, now create a tuple from a iterable object. Tuple is a keyword. Okay, tuple is a keyword for the Python. So here you can write down true or false. It will print the true or false. Okay, this is the iterable objects. Now, how to get an item of a tuple in a Python? So here you can see, here you will come to know so many things. Okay, create a tuple. So create a tuple, you can see, I have created a tuple with a separated by the comma, and I'm printing a simple tuple. Here you can see is the double quotes, but it is printing in the single quotes. Okay, now, if I want to access the fourth element, I think we have cleared, this is 0 index value, this is 1 index value, this is 2 index value, this is 3 index value. If you have not seen the previous chapters, you please go and see the previous videos, and you will get the clarification for this. If please watch the string or the list, you will get the clarification for this index value. Okay, similarly, this is the forward direction, backward direction, minus 1, it is going to be a start. So if I want to access the fourth element, that means 0, 1, 2 and 3, index value 3, but counting 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, index value it is 3, but the counting, if I'm going to counting simply 1, 2, 3 and 4, I want to access this value. So how will I do this? I'm going to access this as I declared a variable item equals to tuple and the index position. And it will give you the output. Okay, it will give you the output. Similarly, you can access the tuple. I think I have created this by mistake. I have created this two times. Okay, it is a separation. I suppose it's supposed to be on the next slide, but don't worry about this. Okay, so here is the same thing. So you can see, get the fourth item from the last. As I told you, it is the index value from the forward direction 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If I am going to talk about the from backward direction, so minus 1, the index value is minus 1, the index value is minus 2, the index value is minus 3. So it is saying the fourth element from the back, 1, 2, 3, 4, means the U you want to access, this U you want to print. So how will I do this? The similar way, index tuple, similar you can see index tuple X. Tuple X, but in the place of 3, here you will get a minus 4, because it is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and it is minus 4. So on the fourth position, it is minus 4, so you will get a U as the output. Okay, I think it is clear to you. Make it sure that shortage of time, I am creating this through the presentation, otherwise I can write down on the programming platform, but make it sure you have to do this practical. Okay, you have to do, because if you want to learn, then you have to do. Okay, so now, how to know if an element existing within a tuple in Python? Okay, so I think in the string we have used in or not in. So there are the two statements. Use this statement, in or not in. Here I declared a tuple with these values. Okay, if I'm going to print this, it is the output of this tuple. Okay, let's see if I am searching print R in tuple X. Print R in tuple X. If R is there, it will print the Boolean operator output true. As we have seen, this in gave the true and false in a previous string chapter. So similarly, you will get a Boolean operator output here. If use in statement 5 in tuple, but one thing I want to tell you here, it is a character or a string type, so you have to put a double quotes here, no need to put, because it is a integer value. So 5 5 in tuple x, so it is false, because no 5 is there. let's suppose if I am going to write down 5 not in tuple x, not in tuple x. Okay, so that time it will show you the true. It will show you the true if I will say not in, not in. Okay, if I will say not in, so it will say true. Actually, I don't have a proper keypad, so by mistake it is going forward. So cop up with me, because I don't know that during this lockdown time I have to teach you. I was thinking that we will meet in the computer lab, but it's very difficult time for everyone. So just cop up with me, just cooperate with me. Okay, now how to convert a list into a tuple? So how will you convert? There is a one important, this is the one important thing. As you know that tuple is immutable and list is mutable. You cannot change the value in immutable terms, but list is mutable. You can change the value. So here you are going to learn how to convert tuple to list. Okay, here I am going to learn how to convert tuple to list and list to tuple, vice versa. Okay, so we are going to discuss this topic, list to tuple and tuple to list. So first of all, here you can see I created a list. By the brackets you should know. Okay, so see the bracket and recognize it is a string. As I told you in the beginning, this is the double quotes string, this bracket, and this bracket is for list, and this bracket is for tuple, and this parenthesis for dictionary. Okay, I think it is clear to all of you. So here is a list. List items are this one. Now you are printing the list. This is the list. Now if you want to convert this, so what you have to do, you have to write down any variable. It's not needed that you have to write down tuple x. You can write down x only. X equals to tuple. This is important thing. Okay, this is important thing. Tuple and the name of this list. So what you are doing, you are converting the elements, whatever is in the list, into a tuple. So here you can see the output edge changes in the bracket. Is this clear to all of you? If yes, please write down as in the program section. Okay, you have to do this programming. Now add the items in Python tuple. There is a one thing which is here. Tuples are immutable, so you cannot add a new element, but there is a cheat codes. As every game have a cheat code, here is the cheat code. That means you can add the values by doing some extra work. So let's see here, tuple, it is a tuple, so output is a tuple is here. So we can use this operator. Okay, concatenate string. Please remember, we have discussed this in a string. Concatenate means combining the values. Okay, so here what I am doing, here you can see tuple x and tuple x plus bracket, in the bracket you have to write down 9 comma. So when you will print this, it will give you this output. Okay, when you are going to print this one, it will give you this output, because earlier it was 4 6 2 8 3 1, 4 6 8 2 8 3 1, and you are going to add 9 at the last, so it will come at the last. Okay, now as you know that we have we can convert this into the list. So here after this we are going to check that we can convert this tuple in the list, then we can add the value, and again we will convert list to tuple. Okay, so let's see here. But first of all, we having some other methods also. As tuple starting to fifth point, starting to fifth point is 0 1 2 3 4 and 5. Starting to fifth point is here, so you can see starting to fifth point, and you are joining with this tuple 50 20 25, and again starting to last point. So here you can see starting to last point, starting to last point, and in the middle there is a value which you have added from this way. Okay, so it is the method to add the values. But we know that we cannot add the value. We cannot delete the value. But here are the some cheats that we can do by these methods. So you have to learn these things. Okay, you have to remember these things. So this is the very important part which I am going to discuss just now. So let's see this area. Okay, this area. As I told you, tuple to list, list to tuple. So here, first of all, what I am going to do? I am going to convert this tuple into the list. Okay. So now, in list we have the append mode, append function which will add the value at the last. So when you are going with this program, so what will happen? It will append this value at the last, and after appending, you are converting this list into the tuple. Okay. You can see tuple list means list to tuple, and here tuple to list. Again, I'm cleaning the screen and I'm going to show you tuple to list and list to tuple. This is very important thing. And every time you can see that list is written here when you are converting tuple to list, and here list to tuple and tuple is written here. Okay, so here is the method that you can add some values, add some variables with your choice, but it is immutable. Now, as you can see that we cannot add the value, we cannot remove the value. In the beginning I told it is immutable, but we can add and we can remove by some cheat codes. So what are the cheat codes we are discussing? So here creating a tuple, tuple is created here. So here W3DRESL, I have written randomly. So this is the important line, please read out yourself. Okay, so here we are going to remove the values. So how we will remove the values? As you can see in the previous thing, we have added these two values. This is the beginning, this is the ending, and this is the middle portion. This is the beginning, this is the ending, this is the middle portion. So similarly, if I am going to remove some values, I can use this one. So you can see here starting to second value. So it is 0, it is 1, it is 2, it is 3, it is 4, 5, 6, and so on. Okay, so we have to access starting to second point, but minus 1. So 0 to 1, 0 to 1, that means W and 3. So here you can see W and 3. Now, we are starting from 3 to last. So 3 to last RESL, you can see RESL, and remember we are leaving this D here. So we removed this one. I think it is pretty clear to all of you. Okay, so convert the list into the tuple, and you can do this thing also again with the help of list. So convert this, convert the tuple to list, and use the remove keyword. You can remove this L alphabet we have removed from here. So you can see this one, and again convert the list to tuple. Okay, make it sure this is very important program that you have to learn. In exam time, the examiner and on question paper you will get this type of questions. So be aware about this thing, how to convert tuple to list and list to tuple. Okay, and maybe this anyone can ask, if list or tuple is immutable, how you can convert as a mutable? By the help of this operators and the conversion of list to tuple and tuple to list. Okay, I think it is pretty clear. So now let's slice a tuple. Slice means slicing the values. So here is a tuple. Create this tuple first of all, then you can start. I think we have discussed in the string also. If you have not seen the video, you please go and watch the first video, string or a list. You will come to know what is the slicing. So here, when you are going to do the slicing, you should know the starting point and the ending point. Starting index and ending index. Index means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever. And in the reverse order, minus 1, minus 2, and so on. So it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, it is 8, and it is 9. Okay, so we have 0 to 9. So let's suppose this is a slicing we are going to do. You can use any variable here, any variable. So you are writing 3 to 5. 5 means 3 to 4, means 3 to 4, these two values. 3 to 4 is 5 and 4. So it is here. Okay, 5 to end, because you are not going to give, you are not giving any last point in last index value you have not given, so it will accept the value from 5th to last. 5th to last means 6 to 1. There is 6 7 8 6 1 6 7 8 6 1. Okay, now when you are not defining the starting index, so starting index, if you are not defining, so it will go up to 5. 6 means up to 5. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here it will print this one only. Okay. So you can take the values from the reverse order also. Okay, I'm going to clean the screen. So here is the screen. Now let's see here. If I want to print the value in the reverse order. In the reverse order. Okay, if suppose examiner asks you to print the values from the reverse order, from the backward side. So you can see minus 3, minus 4, okay, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10. So it is asking 8 to 4, minus 8 to 4. So 8 is here and 4 is here, okay, minus 1, 2, 3 and 4, okay, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so 8 to 4. So it will come in this way. It is not going in this way. It will come in this way. Minus 8, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 7, minus 6, minus 5. Okay, plus 1 bhi karna hai yahan pe. You have to add plus 1. Okay, so now next is the size of a tuple. How you will calculate the size of a tuple? So here you can see a tuple is written in this way. Output is this way. Okay, the length function you can use here to calculate the size, as we have calculated in the length string and in the list. Now plus and asterisk operator we are going to use here. You can see tuple 5, and if I am going to write down tuple asterisk 6, so what will happen, it will print 5 6 times. It will print 5 6 times. Okay, now this is that one tuple, and you want to write down this complete tuple 4 times. So you have to write down like this, means that this asterisk should be outside. Okay, so here 1 2 3, okay, one time, 1 2 3, one time, 1 2 3, one time, and this is one time. So you can see 1 2 3 4 times. Okay, now create the three tuples. Three tuples, you can see here, tuple 1, tuple 2 and tuple 3, and you want to add all these values. So tuple 1 plus operator, tuple 2 plus operator, tuple 3 plus operator, and you are printing this tuple. It is not mandatory that you have to write on this keyword. You can write on A, B, C, X, Y, Z, whatever is your opinion. And you have to print this value, and it will be in this way. We have used already the plus operator. Okay, I think these things are clear. So now here you can see some questions which you can attempt and you can learn. These are the important questions, simple questions you can understand yourself. Okay, if you have any problem, you can ask. Now these are the questions for your self-assessment. You please write down these questions, attempt and check what is the output. If you are having any problem, let me know in the comment section so that I can solve it out. Okay, so thank you, have a nice day. So next topic we will start with the dictionary. So in this pandemic time, remain home, stay safe. God bless you all. Thank you.